Okay, Proverbs 16:23, the heart of the wise teacheth his mouth and addeth learning to his lips. The heart of the wise teacheth his mouth and addeth learning to his lips. Okay, so that shows that once the word of God is firmly established in your heart through meditation. Meditation means that you have to speak the word out where you can hear it with your own what? Ears. Faith comes by what? Hearing, and hearing by what? The word of God. So the person that's most effective in building your faith is actually you. That's the reason why I want to put at your disposal scriptures that will probably give you a fair understanding of God's provisions and God's will for you in just about every arena of your life. Of course, the meditation books we have, we have another meditation book that's going to be ready real soon that's going to cover very critical areas, but you'll get an overview of all of God's provision. For instance, like faithfulness, the area of grace, the area of sanctification and holiness, the area of faith, the area of praise and worship, the area of thanksgiving, the area of healing. You'll have all of this information at your disposal once we get the next meditation book. And then from that point, you can sit down for 4 or 5 hours straight if you in that flow. And you can just go from healing to God's faithfulness to God's what? To thanksgiving. You can go to God's grace. And boy, it makes you so happy. And it fills your, it fulfills your inner longing so thoroughly until most families just break down and weep and cry. Because it's just finger-licking good. The word of God is so good, hallelujah, until it just impacts you and it warms your heart every time. So, but the thing I want to make clear is that when you do things like that, and you are just kind of quietly speaking the word out to yourself, that is equivalent to praying. Praying the word, calling God to remember. Amen. See, some of y'all been worried about, well, I don't pray well. I don't know how to pray. I can't pray like Pastor Hill. Y'all hear me all the time? All I do is what? Just say what God says. Amen. I'm not praying in the spirit. What am I saying? I'm just agreeing with God in his word. I'm just recalling something good that God has what? Said or promised me. And boy, that is good. Yeah. Woo! Yeah. I got that brother Travis trying to do, trying to follow me. Woo! Boy, for hours, so that's all you're going to do. You're going to what? Just say that word. Say that word. Amen. So I just want to encourage you along those lines tonight because this scripture says that, well, let me give you another. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth what? Speaks. So it's a very important how you program the word into your heart, because once you get the word programmed in your heart, then the word of God says here in Proverbs 16:23, it says the heart of the wise is going to what? Teach your mouth. In other words, what's going to come out of your mouth is what you have what? Programmed and established in your heart. All right. Amen. So we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the what? Word of our testimony. So you want this stuff consistently coming out of your heart. And we see this in the book of Daniel as we go through the book of Daniel. You'll see Daniel always speaking in agreement with what? God's word. Amen. Reminding God of what he has said. Jehoshaphat, remember when he prayed that prayer? He said, Lord, you said when when we had famine, when the enemy tried to come against us, when this or that happened, he said, if we would just come before your house and what? Pray. You said you would hear us and you would help us. That's so all he prayed, exactly that prayer that Solomon had prayed much earlier. That's what he prayed. So you always want to stick with the word and you'll come out all right every time. Y'all believe that? All right, so this is a scripture that you want to remember. Is that the heart of the wise teaches his mouth. So when a person is speaking something contrary, that means what? They haven't really, what? They haven't really, amen, praise God. They haven't really did what? When a person begin to talk a lot of negative and stuff that's opposing God's word, that means they haven't done a whole lot with their heart, right? They haven't really been consistent in what putting the right thing in their heart. Because when you put the right thing in your heart, it's going to what manifest through the words that you speak.
Amen.
Somebody said, the word have I what? Hid in my heart that I might not what? Sin against thee. All right. So that is the motivation I had. And the reason why I'm always doing things like this, because I'm trying to get you built up independent of me or even the prayer meetings, because we don't make all the prayer meetings. So you're going to have to find a way to build your own self up. Right? And I'm telling you, if you really want to get a strong prayer life, you get used to what? Speaking God's word out where you can what? Hear it and build yourself up and get your heart what? Full of wisdom. And out of your heart is going to what? Flow. Amen. What you have programmed. Okay, how speaking God's word out. We went over this, so it's not fair to all of the saints because some of us went over these before. But if you haven't gone over these scriptures, it would be very good to go over. Now, Joshua 1:8, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. Alright? So isn't that amazing? Joshua said the word of God should never depart out of your mouth. So this means that when you are doing your meditation on a daily basis, this is what you should be doing. You should be what? You should be speaking the word out, or confessing the word out, or we call it meditating the word out in a way that your spirit can benefit by what? Hearing the words that's coming out of your own mouth. Faith comes by what? Hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Again, when you do that, it's equivalent to praying the word. That's all it is. Praying the word. You can pray the word, and then you can what? You can pray in the spirit. Most times when you pray the word, it's going to motivate you to what? Pray in the spirit more. All right, so that was Joshua's admonition. Don't let the word of God depart out of your mouth. Thou shalt meditate therein day and night that thou mayest observe to do. Now, why do you feel that when you meditate and speak the word out day and night, then he says that ye may observe to do? See, when the word of God is established in your heart, then the next thing is what? Acting on the word. You're going to what? Actually begin to what? Do what it says do. But you're not going to do it until it gets what? Deeply embedded into your heart. And you do that by what? Speaking it out quietly, softly, in the morning at 4 o'clock, 4:30. Is that all right? Take it up a little further. 5 o'clock. 5:30. All right, the early, somebody say, early to bed, early to rise, make a man what?
Healthy,
wealthy, and wise. That's pretty good. I think that's a good philosophy. Get up as early as you can, while it's quiet, while your mind is fresh, before you get involved, begin to what? Speak, program the word into your heart. Amen.
Amen.
That's what Joshua said. You make your way prosperous, and you'll have what? Good success. All right, I'm going to go down this list to see Sister Hill's scripture, favorite scripture. Years ago, she programmed this, and she still said, this is my favorite scripture. Psalm 63, verse 5 and 6. My soul shall be what? Satisfied as with what? Marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall praise thee with what? When I remember thee upon my bed and meditate on thee in the night watch. This is her favorite scripture. Okay, I want somebody to tell me, my tongue is the pen of a ready writer. What does that mean to anybody? My tongue is the pen of a ready writer. My tongue. My tongue is as a pen of a ready writer. Okay. Now I like to write, and I write in the morning early. Boy, I just, it just thrills me. Woo, I get in that zone. I can't get in there all the time, but most times I can. And it's better when the earlier the better. When I get in that zone, them thoughts begin to come to me, man. I just get so, you know, so excited. I just start writing. So your tongue should be as a what? As a pen up already writing. So that means that you ought to be what? Quick and excited. Totally caught up in what? Meditating and speaking the word to God. Okay, I'm just going through that because we've already gone through that. Look at page 23, Psalms 91, 2. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. How many remember the day that we had that prayer on for protection, supernatural protection? How many got that message? Telephone call? Anybody got that telephone call? All right. Okay. Now, the important thing is that many times when we are threatened by tornadoes and things of that nature, many times we'll just say, Lord, I'm just going to trust God. And sometimes we never make a vocal confession. We never say anything verbally. But we'll just be thinking, Lord, I think, you know, we'll just be thinking, the Lord is my protection, He's my provision, He ain't going to let nothing happen to me. But that is not really good enough. For instance, like you said, well, I know the Lord keeps me saved. Be thinking it and never confess it. The Lord is the strength of my life. I can do all things through Christ, which if we never say it. So none of these provisions that we have as believers are really vitally ours. See, there's a legal side of our redemption. A legal side means that the provisions for our healing has already been what? Been made, right? Everybody got that? That's the what legal side of our what redemption. Everybody is healed. And that's the reason why sometimes people get off. Everybody is saved. That's the legal side. Because Christ has what? He's died for all. He's paid the price, right? He committed His love toward us while we were yet sinners. He was the just for the unjust to bring us to God. That has already been what? Accomplished. It's past tense. So the world has already been reconciled to Christ, but everybody is not vitally, although everybody is legally saved, but everybody is not saved in terms of actually what? Receiving Christ. And you can't become, you're not legally saved until you what? You confess Jesus Christ as your what? Lord and Savior. You gotta believe it in your heart and you gotta what? Say it with your what? Mouth before it becomes what? Vitally or yours in reality. Everybody got different? So all of these truths that's legally ours don't become vitally ours until we what? We begin to what? Confess it. Everybody say it? Amen. You'll never be strong just thinking it in your mind. You gotta what? You gotta let the weak what? Say, I'm strong. And the more you say it, the what? More strength is going to be released into your life. And it's the same way about protection against violent weather, storms, tornadoes, and all of that. Although the provisions for our protection has already been what? Paid for. But we got to what? This scripture says, I will what? Say of the Lord, He is my what? Refuge. Psalms 91, all of those provisions in Psalms 91 is contingent upon verse 2. I will what? Say of the Lord, He is my what? So that's the reason why you need to what? Confess Psalms 91. You need to what? Say it. And when you begin to say it, you'll begin to see the reality of all of those provisions that's recorded in that particular book. So it's very important that you know that you're healed. By His stripes, I'm what? I'm healed. But healing in reality does not occur until what? You begin to what? Come into agreement and begin to what? Speak in agreement with God's word. You got to what? Say it. You got to believe it in your heart and you got to do what? Say it. Everybody says say it.